Hello there, this is Ujjwal and welcome to another YouTube tutorial. Today I'm making these adorable, cute and quirky wood slice coasters. These are really simple to do, require very few supplies, and I thought I'd share more of such DIY ideas on the YouTube channel to help you guys create these and try these out at home as well. So let's get started. The things that you'll need are some pre-cut wood slices. These are approximately 3 centimeters in diameter and are easily available in India. Then you need some sort of raisin. I'm using Little Birdie's raisin and hardener here, and some permanent markers, some disposable gloves and paper cups. So to start with, you can write or doodle or design whatever design you want on your coasters. I'm going with a little bit of fun and quirky, so I am doing I'm writing the name of the drinks that we usually have in our house. So it's coffee, tea, water and lemonade, and I'm writing them in Hindi on one side and then in English on the other side. I think it just adds a little bit more fun, you know, having it in Hindi. Now if you struggle with writing or drawing designs, you can use different techniques here. You could use stencils, you can take help from the internet, find a lovely font and then copy that font on your posters. You could trace a design, just anything that you like. Maybe you want to paint them, you can color them. Anything that you wish to do on the coasters is absolutely perfect. Just make sure that it is water resistant, and if you're using a marker, it's a permanent marker or a paint marker that won't run when we, you know, add the resin on top. So you can see I've added the text, and now I'm just preparing to pour the resin. So I have my gloves on. I'm just using some regular medical gloves. These are easily available at any chemist shop. And then I'm using a piece of scrap cardboard and then some paper cups on which my little one doodled. So yeah, she was just keeping busy while I was shooting the video. So I'm just using them, those paper cups, to increase the height and put the coasters on. And now to mix the resin. Now there is a lot of different variety of resin available on the internet. This one by Little Birdie is a fast drying resin, so you have to be careful and work really quickly. And the resin, the clear resin and the hardener, is to be mixed in a 1-to-1 ratio. The instructions are all available on the packaging, but still you need to mix them in equal amounts and then mix them really well and work quickly, like say 5 to 10 minutes is the max you have to, you know, work with this resin before it starts to harden out. So yeah, it's great for people who are like me and are not patient enough and just want quick results. So you can work with this resin. There are other resins which have a drying time of 24 hours, 12 hours. Just do your research and try a few and see which one works better for you. Now, I wanted to share this tip with you here. You see, I directly applied the resin onto the wood surface. This wood surface was porous, so it soaked in the resin. The resin seeped inside it, and you see that's why there is a change of color on the coasters that I have resin on, while the other ones that I don't have the resin on are still a different color. So this mistake made me use a lot of resin then actually needed, because most of the resin seeped through and I had to keep applying resin on top to get that glossy finish. So the way to correct this is to seal your wood surface first. So when I worked on the other side of the coasters with resin, what I did was I used a gel medium. You can use a clear gesso or even Mod Podge, and I did a coat of that, a very light coat of that, on the wood slice before I added the resin. What that did was it sealed the wood surface and it made it non-porous. So when I added my resin, the resin did not seep through. So this is one tip that I wanted to share with you. Now here you can see these this side, the Hindi side of the coasters, is coated with a gel medium, and you can see the color is not changing like it changed when I did the other side. So if you want to save on your resin and preserve the original color of your coasters, you can use a protective layer of Mod Podge or a gel medium or even a clear gesso works, and then once it dries, then you apply your resin coating. So yeah, that was my first tip. That was the first thing that I encountered and I thought I'd share with you, so that, you know, it'll save you trouble when you try to do it yourself. Another thing was that I had done a little bit of research, not a lot, about the resin, and although this resin does not leave a lot of bubbles, the bubbles are very, very few and easy to get rid of, but I had some on my surface and I thought, let's give this heat gun thing a try, and well, it did not work at all. You can see how coaster is, and that's because I blew hot air from my heat gun onto this particular coaster, and I regret it so much because obviously I was blowing hot air, the air got trapped inside the resin and made even more bubbles. So do whatever, but please do not use a heat gun on your resin work. Use a blowtorch or a heat torch, that works. You need to give it heat but not heated air. So yeah, learning from mistakes here, and I hope you don't make the same mistakes. So but it was so fun, this project turned out really, really cool, and I'm using these coasters in my home and my daughter loves it, my husband loves it. So I hope you give these a try. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you give it a try, do let me know, do share with me, and spread the DIY fever. So yeah, see you again next time, and take care. Bye bye.